ZebraLight is a company based in Texas that makes a wide variety of LED flashlights and headlamps that run on either single AA or 18650 cells. The lights are all simple tube designs made from anodized aluminum with a single button. The LEDs they use are mostly the latest Cree emitters that have high efficiency and high brightness. The H600 series of headlamps run on a single 18650 lithium-ion battery, and the high brightness, relatively small size and weight, and good durability of these lights make them a great backup light for caving. However, many cavers have been using them as their primary, and a common setup is to mount a pair of them on the front of the helmet. With two lights, you can mix beam patterns, generate double the lumen output, and have redundancy in case one or the other fails or needs a battery replaced. They also work great as light sources for photography and videography. Since they take standard single 18650 cells, there are many economical sources for batteries, and the batteries are standardized. A dual ZebraLight setup, including several batteries and a charger, will cost around $250, which is very cost competitive with other premium headlamp systems. It's a challenge to navigate the array of different ZebraLight models. The H600 series is now in its fourth generation, in which there are three options for beam patterns and four options for LED temperature and CRI, for a total of 12 different headlamps. There are then another 16 varieties of the older generation H600 lights that are also still available, with most of the same features, just slightly lower lumen outputs. For beam patterns, they have a flood, floody, and spill plus spot options. The flood pattern is a bare emitter with a reflector that generates a very uniform beam with a roughly 120 degree angle. The floody pattern has a roughly 90 degree beam angle with a hybrid pattern that contains a lot of flood and a slightly brighter spot area in the middle. The spill plus spot pattern is similar to the floody, but with more intensity in the spot area. The emitters they offer include a 5700 Kelvin cool white LED that is close to daylight temperature, and a more neutral 4500 Kelvin emitter. They also now have two high CRI emitters at color temperatures of 5000 and 4000 Kelvin. High CRI is a little difficult to understand, but it's sort of a measure of color accuracy, with 100 being ideal. For general caving use, it doesn't make much difference, but for photography or videography, the colors look more true to life if you use a high CRI light source. The H600 series headlamps take a single 18650 cell. It's a good idea to use a protected cell, but the light has some built-in protection circuitry as well. To prevent the light from being turned on accidentally, you can screw the tail cap on all the way and then back it off about half a turn. The ZebraLights have a single button, but there's an amazing number of adjustments that can be made with this one input. There are three standard light modes described as low, medium, and high. Pressing and releasing the button once will turn on the high mode. A double press will turn on the light in medium mode. Pressing and holding the button will cycle through all three modes, starting with low, and the button can be released when it's at the desired level. For each of the low, medium, and high levels, there's a secondary level that can be accessed with a double click of the button. The lower output secondary level can be programmed to one of three settings, but changing this is complicated. Refer to ZebraLight's user manual for more information. There are also several strobe modes available, but these are of limited use to cavers. There is also a battery charge indicator. With the light turned off, click the button four times quickly. The LED will flash from one to four times to indicate the battery's state of charge, with four flashes being fully charged. ZebraLights have current and lumen regulated output, and the three highest lumen settings are also thermally regulated. This PID thermal control kicks in pretty quick since the lights are fairly small and there's only so much you can do with heat dissipation with such a small mass. The result is that the actual lumen output at these higher settings isn't maintained for very long, and the runtimes advertised aren't really reflective of the actual lumen outputs. For the other settings, ZebraLight claims that their lumen ratings are ANSI certified, which is a method for measuring the actual amount of light emitted from the front of the lamp. This OTF, or out the front rating, is typically 15-20% lower than the lumens produced by the emitter, but is a more honest and accurate way to report lamp intensity. ZebraLights have a reasonably good reputation for reliability. I've had two failures over many years of use. The first was due to a small amount of corrosion on the battery spring. Since the unit must be opened every time batteries are changed, there's a greater chance of introducing moisture or humidity. But cleaning off the corrosion restored its function. The other was a complete failure of the light to turn on. This happened within the one-year warranty period and the lamp was replaced, though the process did take 14 weeks. There are just a few things I don't like about the ZebraLights. The single battery requires frequent changes if using it as a primary light. There are far too many modes, and the button presses to make all these changes is very complicated. The beam patterns for a single light are fixed, and none of the lights has a good focused spot beam. Finally, the magnetic field generated by the internal battery may affect compass or disto X readings, so caution must be used while surveying. Some things I like about the ZebraLights include the simple, lightweight, rugged, and waterproof design. The relatively broad beam patterns are very good for general caving use. and the flood beam and High Sierra eye lamp is great as a photography or videography light. In general, I think the features of these lights make them the best all-around backup headlamp, but the shorter run times and limited beam patterns mean that I still favor lights such as the Manly, Scurion, or Stan as a primary headlamp.